King Arthur, and these are my knights of the Round Table. Whose castle is this?
This is the castle of my master, Guido Luamba.
Go and tell your master that we have been charged by God with a sacred quest. If he will give us food and shelter for the night, he can join us in our quest for the Holy Grail.
He's already got one.
Well, can we come up and have a look?
Of course not. You are English types.
Well, what are you then?
I'm French.
What are you doing in England?
Mind your own business.
If you will not show us the Grail, we shall take your castle by force.
You don't frighten us, English pig dogs.
What a strange person.
Now look here, my good man.
I don't want to talk to you no more, you empty-headed animal food trough whopper. I fart in your general direction. Now go away or I shall taunt you a second time.
Now this is your last chance.
I've been more than reasonable.
Defeat at the castle seems to have utterly disheartened King Arthur. Arthur, having consulted his closest knights, decided that they should separate and search for the Grail individually. Now this is what they did.
The Tale of Sir Robin. So each of the knights went their separate ways. Sir Robin rode north through the dark forest of Ewing, accompanied by his favorite minstrels.
Bravely bold Sir Robin rode forth from Camelot. He was not afraid to die, oh brave Sir Robin. He was not at all afraid to be killed in nasty ways. Brave, 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 brave Sir Robin. He was not in the least bit scared to be mashed into a pulp, or to have his eyes gouged out and his elbows broken, to have his kneecap split and his body burned away, and his limbs all hacked and mangled, brave Sir Robin. His head smashed in and his heart cut out and his liver removed and his bowels unplugged and his nostrils raked and his bottom burnt off and his penis...
That's enough music for now, lads. Looks like there's dirty work afoot.
He is brave Sir Robin, brave Sir Robin.
Shut up! Nobody really. I'm just passing through.
What do you want?
To fight.
Shut up! Nothing really. I just to pass through, good Sir Knight.
I'm afraid not.
Ah, well, actually, I am a Knight of the Round Table.
You're a Knight of the Round Table?
I am.
In that case, I shall have to kill him. All right. We'll kill him first, and then have tea and biscuits.
Yes. Oh, not biscuits.
All right. Not biscuits. Let's kill him anyway.
Right.
He's buggered off.
So he has. He's scarpered.
Brave Sir Robin ran away.
No.
Bravely ran away.
I didn't.
When danger reared its ugly head, he bravely turned his tail and
fled.
Yet brave Sir Robin turned about.
I didn't.
And gallantly he chickened out, bravely taking.
I never did.
He beat a very brave retreat.
Oh, Lord.
Bravest of the brave Sir Robin.
I never.
The Tale of Sir Galahad. On to scene 24, which is a smashing scene with some lovely acting, in which Arthur discovers a vital clue.
And this enchanter of whom you speak, he has seen the Grail? Where does he live? Old man, where does he live?
Seek you the Bridge of Death.
The Bridge of Death which leads to the Grail?
The knights who say nay.
The knights who say nay demand a sacrifice. Nay! 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 We shall say nay again to you if you do not appease us.
Well, what is it you want?
We want a shrubbery! Now, go!
The Tale of Sir Lancelot.
Well taken, Concord.
Thank you, sir.
Most kind.
And again. Over we go. Good, steady. And now, the big one. Come on, Concord.
Message for you, sir.
To whoever finds this note, I have been imprisoned by my father. I am in the tall tower of Swamp Castle at last.
This could be the sign that leads us to the Holy Grail. Brave, brave Concord. You shall not have died in vain.
I'm not quite dead, sir. Actually, I think I'm all right to come with you.
No, sweet Concord, stay here.
No, I feel fine, actually.
Farewell, sweet Concord.
I'll just stay here then, shall I, sir? Yeah.
Behold your humble servant, Sir Lancelot of Camelot. I've come to take you... Oh, I'm terribly sorry.
You got my note!
Well, I got a note.
You've come to rescue me!
Listen.
Who are you?
I'm your son.
No, not you!
I'm Sir Lancelot, sir.
Hurry, Sir Lancelot! Hurry! I'm ready!
Would you like to come and have a drink?
Well, that's awfully nice of you.
I am ready!
I mean, to be so understanding. Say, when I'm in this idiom, I sometimes get a bit sort of carried away.
Oh, don't worry about that.
Old crow, is there anywhere in this town where we could buy a shrubbery?
Who sent you?
The knights who say ni.
Ah, no. Never, we have no shrubberies here.
If you do not tell us where we can buy a shrubbery, my friend and I will say, we will say, ni.
Ah, do your worst.
Very well. If you will not assist us voluntarily, ni.
No. Never. No shrub.
That's it. You've got it.
Ni.
Ni.
Ni. Ni.
Are you saying ni to that old woman?
Yes.
There is a pestilence upon this land. Nothing is sacred. Even those who arrange and design shrubberies are under considerable economic stress at this period in history.
Did you say shrubberies?
Yes. Shrubberies are my trade. I am a shrubber. My name is Roger the Shrubber. I arrange, design, and sell shrubberies.
Ni!
No!
O Knights of Ni, we have brought you your shrubbery. May we go now?
It is a good shrubbery. I like the laurels particularly. But there is one small problem.
What is that?
Firstly, you must find another shrubbery!
Not another shrubbery!
Then, when you have found the shrubbery, you must place it here beside this shrubbery. Only slightly higher, so you get a two-level effect with a little path running down the middle. Then, when you have found the shrubbery, you must cut down the mightiest tree in the forest with a
throwing knife!
Right!
Wait!
gadget.
He is jacking it in and packing it up and sneaking away and buggering off and chickening out and pissing up home. Yes, Bravely, he is throwing in the spy.
Robin, my lead. It's good to see you.
Beyond the forest, they met Lancelot, and there was much rejoicing. In the frozen land of Nador, they were forced to eat Robin's minstrels. And there was much rejoicing. And winter gave spring and summer a miss and went straight on into autumn. Until one day.